Hello, ladies and gentlemen, non-road user again. I was reading a tweet earlier on today from a gentleman called Ian Blades, inviting people to join him on a Labour doorstep. Now, for those who are unfamiliar with this Labour doorstep thing, apparently what goes on is people either in some way involved with the Labour Party go around various areas knocking on people's doors, and I would imagine the purpose of that would be to try and convince people to, place their vote for whoever the Labour Party have selected, be it councillors or, MPs or whatever. I don't know. Look, I know, jack really about politics, other than that people, going around knocking on doors annoys the life out of me, right? But interestingly, in this tweet, which I'm gonna throw up on a screen grab, and I can't actually see the tweet at the moment, I'm working from memory. It said something like, "Come and join us on the Labour doorstep. DM me." This is from this Ian Blades, right? "DM me," which means direct message, "or phone me." Phone number in his profile or something like that. "All are welcome," or words to that effect, right? Now that got me thinking, right? If all are welcome, how do they know that they aren't going to attract, for want of a better word, undesirables, right? Let's just play out a hypothetical scenario, ladies and gentlemen. Okay, say that I am a right wrong'un, right? And I go around burgling people's houses, or I'm a con man and I, like to go around conning people on the doorstep. And if I saw this tweet as that sort of person, I would kind of think all my Christmases have come early, because from what I'm seeing, I can't see any form of vetting procedure, right? It just seems to me that all you do is you either send this guy a direct message on Twitter, or you phone him up on his mobile, I imagine, and say, "I'd like to come along to this Labour doorstep. Can you pick me up? I'll meet you on Linthorpe Road," or something like that, right? And this is how I'm perceiving it works, right? I could be wrong. I hope I'm wrong, right? And then he rocks up, picks it up, drives it to wherever, right? And then you go around knocking on doors. Now, say for example, you're going around with these people knocking on doors, and you come across a frail old lady, a pensioner, right? Who's like hobbling to the door on a walking stick or a Zimmer frame or something, and you're having a look around and you're thinking, yeah, she looks like she's got a few bob, right, stuck away under the mattress or something, right? I'll come back here later on and either do the place over or knock on the door and say, "Oh, hello, do you remember me? I came round with the Labour doorstep earlier on. Can I just forgot to tell you, blah blah," and then they go into the pitch and totally bamboozle her, and then before you've turned round, she's about 300 quid light or something like that, right? It's just this scenario that's going around in my head, right? And I'm wondering where the vetting is in this process, right? If people from the Labour Party are asking people to come and join them, then surely, excuse me, there must be some sort of vetting procedure. Surely. It's just common sense, isn't it? But from what I'm seeing, I don't think that's happening. So if anybody, like I know there's like people involved with politics who subscribe to my YouTube channel, and I know there's people involved in politics keep an eye as best they can on what I tweet out and stuff, right? Okay, fine, I've got nothing to hide. We've got free speech in this country. I'm entitled to my opinion. I'm quite happy for people to prove me wrong. In fact, I would hope that you could prove me wrong, because if I'm right, this just doesn't bear thinking about, does it? It has all the potential for a total disaster for somebody, and it certainly won't be the Labour Party, I would imagine, right? Be some poor old granny who's been done over by a con man, possibly. That's my take on it, ladies and gentlemen. Please, anyone involved, with this Labour doorstep carry on, right? Please do prove me wrong. I hope that I am wrong, but I just have a sneaky suspicion that this Labour doorstep thing hasn't been fully thought out. So we shall wait and see what comes back. Right, thanks for watching, ladies and gentlemen. I will catch you all later. Bye.